Okay, everyone. So in this segment over here, we've got our Wetumhanga. As John mentioned, we started the Wetumhanga Breeding Program in 2009. So that was started with individuals from Little Barrier Island, which is the only place that Wetumhanga was still existing.
At the exhibit, you'll get to see our New Zealand native kiwi, Epo and Tapu. We have an amazing otter enclosure with five short-clawed Asian otters. We've got a large eel platform where there'll be some eel feeding, and it's going to be really exciting. We hope you come along.
So because kiwi are active during the night time, they're quite sensitive to bright light and also to loud noise. We've got some nice thick glass in our kiwi house, which minimises the noise that goes through. But it's very important when you see kiwi to be nice and quiet and make sure any cameras and phones are switched off.
Good afternoon, and great to be with you on a very special occasion today, where we're opening the new kiwi forest and its two special occupants, which are Tapu and Epo.
We opened up with a calf tray and a farm in 2003, I think. Tropical Butterfly House followed in 2004. And then 2009 was a really significant leap forward for us, because up to then it was mum, dad's little kids, and we were perceived to be interested in that market. We brought in those two really big saltwater crocodiles from Australia. That was 3 years of process applications to IRMA in those days, and got to get approvals through in time. And I must say, it's the most enjoyable time of being in the business, travelling up to the north of Australia, going to crop farms, and just having a really good time looking for two good crocs. crop. So, and not forgetting, of course, we're in a part of Auckland where a lot of the kids, we do a lot of school visits and educational groups who don't usually go into the zoo or other parts of Auckland. A lot of those kids may not get to see kiwi or tuatara, if you ever get the real one, you've got a plastic one, or weka or other New Zealand species. So we like to think that we're going to be pretty popular with even more school groups in South Auckland. Kids who don't get those opportunities to see New Zealand species and, you know, the role they play in our New Zealand environment.